classes. Actually, yesterday we have explained osmotic pressure and osmosis, right? So today we'll continue the topic, that is osmotic pressure. Osmotic pressure. So already I told you the pressure required to stop the osmosis, that is called osmotic pressure, and explain how to calculate molecular weight from osmotic pressure. Now today I have to discuss about what are isotonic solutions, what are hypertonic solutions, what are hypotonic solutions. So first one is isotonic solutions. Isotonic solutions. So isotonic solutions means, if consider two solutions, osmotic pressure is, for one solution is pi 1 and another solution is pi 2. Now the two solutions osmotic pressure is equal, that is pi 1 is equal to pi 2, that is called isotonic. Iso means same. If two solutions osmotic pressure is pi 1 and pi 2, pi 1 and pi 2, that solutions have same osmotic pressure. So now it is defined, the solutions have same osmotic pressure, means equal, pi 1 is equal to pi 2, means same osmotic pressure is called what? Isotonic solution. Means what? Pi 1 is equal to pi 2. This is primary, that is important, that is matter. Pi 1 is always equal to pi 2. For this kind of solutions, what is the example? For example, human blood is isotonic with 0.9% weight by volume NaCl, 0.9% weight by volume NaCl is nothing but saline, is isotonic with blood. Isotonic with blood, that is why if the saline is injected into the blood never clot, because pi value is same, means osmotic pressure is same. So osmotic pressure is same means everything is same. Everything is means what? Concentration also same. For example, pi 1 is equal to pi 2. Then pi is directly proportional to the concentration. Now pi 1 is directly proportional to the C 1, where pi 2 is directly proportional to the C 2. Osmotic pressure is directly proportional to the concentration of first solution. Pi 2 is directly proportional to concentration of the C 2. Now it can written as pi 1 is directly proportional, directly proportional. Here C 1 is nothing but what? So pi 1 pi 2 is equal. Here C 1 C 2 also equal. C 1 means what? N 1 by V 1. Means N 1 is present in V value. Here N2 also present in V value. But then N1 means what? Number of moles, no? Weight by W1 by M1V is equal to W2 by, that is M2V. M2V. So every conditions also important. This is primary condition. what is the primary condition for isothermal solution means primary condition is pi 1 is equal to pi 2 pi 2 remaining are secondary these are based on pi osmotic pressure now this is called isothermal solutions isothermal solution means the solutions in which one solution is osmotic pressure is equal to the another solution of osmotic pressure right so here pi 1 pi 2 these two are osmotic pressures of two solutions osmotic pressure is equal this kind of solutions example is human blood means what RBC is isotonic with 0.9% weight by volume NaCl so 0.9% weight by volume NaCl is called saline is called saline so this is isotonic solution next one is what is hypertonic solution so hypertonic solution means the solutions in which one of the solution is osmotic pressure is greater than another solution so hypertonic solutions what is hypertonic solutions the solutions in which one of the solution osmotic pressure is higher than another solution osmotic pressure so if one solution osmotic pressure is greater than another solution osmotic pressure then what happens what leads to the hypertonic solutions for example the cell placed in is greater than 0.9% weight by volume NaCl a cell means human cell any cell tissue placed in greater than 0.9% weight by volume NaCl then what happens is greater than means this concentration is more 0.9 per greater than means the concentration of the solution is more now this concentration is low cell concentration is low now what is osmosis the solvent is moved from lower concentration to higher concentration what happened the cell is containing water no that water is enters into the greater than 0.9% of NaCl now that is 0.9% NaCl but concentration is greater than now when tissue is this is cell dissolved in it so this is the cell what happened the cell inside the solution is come outside then what happened this cell should be shrink so this is what happened next one is what happened this is the cell position this is the cell position Now it is normal and shell, but it should be what? Shrink. So solution is increase. So that means what? Now we are going to get shrink. So this is called what? Endoosmosis. Exoosmosis. Exoosmosis. This is called what? Exoosmosis. So now this phenomena is called, that is called what? Plasmolysis. 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 Or plasmolysis. Plasmolysis. So in plasmolysis, what happens? The cell containing water that is kept in higher concentration solution. Now the solution inside of cell is come outside. Now it is better shrink. This is called what? Exoosmosis. This process is called what? Plasmolysis. What is hypotonic? What is hypotonic solution? What is hypotonic solution? Hypotonic solution means the solutions in which one of the solution is containing less osmotic pressure than another solution. So the solutions, the solutions in which one of the solution contains lesser osmotic pressure than other solution osmotic pressure means what? One solution, for this one pi 1 is greater than pi 2 or pi 2 is greater than pi 1, any one of solution. If concentration pi 1 is more, now it is greater than pi 2. If pi 2 is greater than, with more concentration, you know, it is greater than pi 1. But here what? Pi 1 is less than pi 2. But if pi 1 is less than here, pi 1 is less than here. Pi 1 is more concentration, no? Here pi 1 is less concentration. Otherwise, pi 2 is less than pi 1. Here greater than, here less than, and the isotonic solution is equal. So this kind of solution, when hypotonic solutions, what happens? Now generally hypotonic solutions, what type of processes take place means, that is endoosmosis. Endoosmosis take place. Endoosmosis. For this one, what happened? When cell kept in less than 0.9% weight by volume NaCl. Weight by volume NaCl. What happened? Less than means now cell concentration is small. Now this in which the solution is enters into the cell. Now this cell is get a what? Swell. Now after it called what? Getting to burst. So this is called hemolysis. Hemolysis. So this is based on osmotic pressure. The solutions are classified three types, that is isotonic solutions, हाइपरटोनिक सॉल्यूशंस, हाइपरटोनिक सॉल्यूशंस ड्यू टू हाइपरटोनिक सॉल्यूशंस व्हाट हैपेंस, व्हाट इज हाइपरटोनिक सॉल्यूशंस एंड व्हाट हैपेंस व्हेन सेल इज कीप्ड इन कंसंट्रेशन ऑफ NaCl, हायर कंसंट्रेशन ऑफ NaCl, लोअर कंसंट्रेशन ऑफ NaCl. सो दिस इज ऑस्मोटिक प्रेशर. नेक्स्ट व्हाट इज रिवर्स ऑस्मोसिस. सो रिवर्स ऑस्मोसिस मींस सो द प्रेशर इज अप्लाइड मोर देन रिक्वायर्ड प्रेशर टू सॉल्यूशन साइड, वी हैव टू सेपरेट सॉल्वेंट फ्रॉम सॉल्यूशन, दैट इज कॉल्ड रिवर्स ऑस्मोसिस. दैट इज कॉल्ड व्हाट? रिवर्स ऑस्मोसिस. So reverse osmosis where you have to use means generally desalination of water means if you want separate the fresh water means if you prepare fresh water from sea water. So this is the process you have to use to remove the fresh water from sea water. So that is reverse osmosis. Reverse osmosis. So what is the reverse osmosis here in diagram? Now it is now this is salt water. Salt water, right? Now this is fresh water. Salt water means what? Sea water. Sea water. Sea water. Now this is semi-permeable membrane. Semi-permeable membrane. Now how to separate? So actually, the solution, the solvent is travel to move to solution. This is called what? Osmosis. Osmosis. Now reverse process is called what? RO, reverse osmosis. Reverse osmosis. Now we have to apply more than required pressure in salt side, salt water side. Now it is pressure is greater than required pressure. The pressure is, that is, you have to apply. The pressure is applied. How much pressure is it? More than required pressure. More than required pressure applied to sea water side. Then what happens? That semi-permeable membrane to allow the solvent. Your sea water is what? Solute is a salt. Solvent is a water. That solvent enters into the fresh water through semi-permeable membrane. When enters into what? Now this salt solution is converted into fresh water. Now we have to collect the fresh water here. If the minimum amount of pressure is, the minimum pressure is applied means that is called what? Osmotic pressure. If more than required pressure is applied, more than required pressure is applied, that is called what? Reverse osmosis. So reverse osmosis where it is used for, that is example is desalination. For desalination process we have to use this one. So this is very very important. Explain desalination process means this is the desalination. So this is the two beakers, one is containing salt water, another containing fresh water. If applied more than required pressure to salt solution side, here what happens? Salt solution means salt plus water. Salt plus water. Here salt is a solute, water is a solvent. Now this, what is the importance of semipermeable membrane? This is a membrane to allow the solvent particles through in it. Now if you hear, solvent is passed from salt solution into fresh water through semipermeable membrane. So now it is converted to fresh water. This process is called what? Desalination. So removal of salt. Removal of salt. If salt is removed, then it is converted into what? Fresh water. So this is a process to collect the fresh water from seawater. This is desalination. So this is the qualitative properties. This was our. And one more point is there. So van der Waals to introduce, that is van der Waals factor. First, I will tell you later this one. Next one, van der Waals factor. Actually, in Colgate properties, some solutions in which solute particles they containing abnormal molar mass. Abnormal molar mass. This is happened because of association and dissociation. When the molecules undergoes association, what happens? And the molecules undergoes dissociation, what happens? That is tomorrow I will going to explain. But briefly I will explain. Again tomorrow I will going to explain. Van der factor is I is equal to normal molar mass by abnormal molar mass. So this abnormal molar mass is formed by due to association dissociation of solute. So I is for van der Waals factor for dissociation is equal to number of ions in the solution. For I is equal to 0, that solution is called non-electrolytes or weak electrolytes. Weak electrolytes. I is greater than 1, it is called the molecule is undergoes dissociation. I is less than 1, it is undergoes association. So tomorrow I will go to explain what is van der Waals factor, what is abnormal molar mass. For association, dissociation, what happens, and also explain problems based on osmotic pressure and depression of freezing point. Right? Thank you so much.